Alright, welcome back. Oh, gotta wait for the thunder to finish. Anytime you feel like it, thunder. Okay, welcome back to Relics of Hyrule, the series. This is episode 61. I'm going to quickly go through Shimmermist Cave. Because there are not only one, but two things in here. One major thing that I want. This is the last place of the guaranteed Giant's Ingot. And also there's a weapon in here, so let's go on in. I'm going to hit some people with some arrows. That's what's going to happen. And then we're going to start the Ruptured Towers. I'm confident that I'll be able to get through both Shimmermist Cave and the first Ruptured Tower by the end of this episode. Because, let's face it, I'm pretty strong at this point. Was that a Skulltula? It was not? Oh, no, it was. No, it wasn't. Just a frog-like spider. They do look similar. Skulltulas just have brighter colors. Let's see, is there anything down here? That fairy will help. A little. Ooh. The green fairy makes everything else, everything look even more sickly. What am I doing? They're blind. They don't care. Ooh, it's warming up. I'm thinking. Might as well keep the green fairy. I don't need it because it's pretty well lit in here right now. What's this guy? How are you doing? Falmer Arrow Dumok. Oh, I sense my spidey sense is tingling. There they are. Palmer Lore Master. That means he's gonna have. Oh! Are you dead? Yeah, he's dead. A lesser Snow Elf arrow and normal Snow Elf arrows. Nice. I'm not sure about that Ash Rod. Oh, what's this? Oh, this is the rest of Shimmermist Cave. Shimmermist Grotto. Yeah, see, Shimmermist Cave isn't that long. So I'll be able to do it, reforge the Biggoron sword, and then be back home for tea. You know what, I'm going to use some poison, because I have a lot of frostbite venom. Whoop. What just activated? Side effect. Oh, it's because I successfully used a poison. Nice. Very cool. Oh, it's already poisoned. I do like that poison, though. What is Frostbite? Oh. Oh, he had a Falmer Dagger. Goat horns. Oh, that's a goat. No wonder he had goat horns. Oh, gonna get that poison. Ancient text. Smoke bomb. Charis knows I'm here. Charis is dead. Charis was chewing on a bone. And I anticipate an enemy in here somewhere. There he is. Well, they're dead. Ebony Bow of Phantoms. I'll disenchant that one right now. Place it. There. Yes, that's what I want. Oh yeah, I got this thing, which I can disenchant, which would be useful. Alright. Got it off of Stalfos, if I remember correctly. Oh, hey buddy! Got magic. I'm gonna quick save, because I'm getting close to the end. In fact, I think this is the end. It looks completely I remember this place looking so drab and empty. But with all this, I don't have a lighting mod, I just have a more powerful computer.
Shadow Master.
Okay, you know what I'm gonna do for this guy is a fire arrow. Just one fire arrow. Hey! And of course, fire arrows explode. I'm gonna use these corundum arrows. And it's down. Bloop. What does Shadow Master have? Shadow Master Honefalmer Dagger. And a River Betty. And this guy. Dwarven Oil, which I will take. Centurion Dynamo Core. Grand Soul Gems. Will help us make, Ooh, the Claw Shot! That's the weapon from this location. This guy. And I know around here is the last giant's ingot. There it is. It's in this chest. That's kind of cool. So we have the last giant's ingot, and we have the claw shot. So the claw shot, it's supposed to disarm enemies. So let's see if I can get it to disarm one of these guys. Well. It's a little... It makes them stagger. It's a guaranteed stagger. It might not be working on them. It's, It was tough to get it to work. So it may be a little funky. So I'll see about fixing that if it is broken. But, yeah. So, Claw Shot, really cool. Based on the same model as the Hook Shot. Retextured and recolored. And the Claw looks is a pretty Dwemer. which seems to imply that the drummer found it and fixed it. And something else about the claw shot. There's the claw. No, I don't want to say. There we go. So you can see the claw. You can see that it's not perfect. The claw sort of comes out of thin air. But it's a really detailed projectile. I like how it turned out. Alright, let's pop over to the Terminan Forge. We'll need a bunch of stuff, leather strips and other stuff to make the Biggoron sword. So I will bring you back once I have collected everything that I need and I'm at the Terminan Forge. Okay, I have everything I need. I have the giant's knife, one corundum ingot, three giant's ingots, two samples of dwarven oil, and four leather strips. And that will allow me to reforge the Biggoron sword. And, might as well make a bomb flower while I'm at it. Or bomb flower seeds. Okay. I'm going to store something in here. I'm going to store it over here. I no longer need the Zora Halberd because the Biggoron sword is naturally stronger. So I'm going to put the Zora Halberd away. Zora Halberd goes away. Winkle's crossbow needs to be placed in my favorites list. Okay, that should be good. Sheikah throwing dagger, I should use those. Alright. Okay. It is time to return to the Shattered Lands and enter the Ruptured Towers and start the Ruptured Towers today, right now. So, without further ado, here we go. Alright, I'm here, I'm back in the Ruptured Towers. I'm gonna start this first one. This is the forest-themed tower. Draws a lot of inspiration from the Great Deku Tree. This is Doubt. And you can see the banner up there. There's the symbol of the Sage Medallion of Forest, and then in two different versions of Hylian, it says Forest and Doubt. So, I have the Biggoron sword ready and prepared. Let's do this. The thing about the Ruptured Towers is that your followers can't follow you, so you have to rely on other things, and each dungeon, each tower will give you a summon, just a single scroll to summon an enemy, summon an ally. And I have a few summoning spells that I can use. I can summon a bunch of Atronox, I can summon the Pestos, Gimos. Okay, this is the entrance, the foyer of Doubt, uses Telemithrin architecture, which fits really well. And you will notice there's a Spriggan over there, there's a Gossip Stone over there, and then over here there's an Armos. And the Armos is sort of guarding Scroll of Spriggan Thrall, so we can summon a Spriggan to help us, and then a poem. Each one has a poem. This one is Stopping by Woods on a Snowy Evening by Robert Frost. Whose woods these are, I think I know. His house is in the village, though. He will not see me stopping here to watch his woods fill up with snow. My little horse must think it queer to stop without a farmhouse near, between the woods and frozen lake, the darkest evening of the year. He gives his harness spells a shake to ask if there is some mistake. The only other sounds the sweep of easy wind and downy flake. The woods are lovely, dark, and deep, but I have promises to keep, and miles to go before I sleep. So each poem was very carefully chosen to reflect something, and it becomes more clear as it goes on. Stopping my woods on a snowy evening echoes the opening of Majora's Mask, Link is walking through the Lost Woods with Epona, and whose woods these are, I think I know. His house is in the village, though. You can think of that referring to either the Great Deku Tree or Mido, as in the Kokiri Forest. Yeah. All right. Someone's not happy, so let's take it. Don't want to pick up too much, because the Ruptured Towers, there's a lot of stuff in it, so I don't want to do too much. So we've gotten care of that. We've taken care of that. So let's go down this spiral staircase of spiraliness, and now it's all foggy. Another sprig in there. How's it going? Jeez. She has anything? I'm not gonna pick up tap roots. It's not gonna be worth it. I will pick up these though. I need to fix that Spriggan's ambush, because she's stuck in the wall. A rare Tektite! That is very nice. Rare Tektite jelly, very cool. Okay, so this room does not look very friendly. I will take a screenshot of it, though. There's a dead Skulltula over there, and there's a chest. So I'm gonna quickly run over to that chest. But it's the gas. The room is filled with poisonous gas. So the solution is to actually just get through this as quickly as possible. I'm gonna pull this. Oh, jeez. And then, so that room is brutal, because it, like, halves your hit points if you're not careful, which I wasn't. And it also, you get met with a Spriggan right afterwards. Oh, come on. There we go. Now, we have another friend coming up. Not a very friendly friend. There he is. It's, Wolfos. How's it going, buddy? He doesn't seem to want to attack me from over there. We have Hidden Viper. Ooh. I wonder if I can disenchant that. Hello! I have Wolfos. Okay. Now we have a room of mushroomy goodness. There's a few ways to solve this puzzle. It can't be done unless you have Whirlwind Sprint or the Rock's Cape. And fortunately, I do have the rock's cape. So, gotta jump across all of these. It's not the easiest thing in the world. Oh, nope. Almost fell off. That was almost terrible. Okay. Yeah. This is the hardest one to get. I wonder. Hover boots might help. No. Yes, the hover boots will definitely help. No, come on. Jump. Nope. Okay. Come on. Nope. Yeah, there we go. Excellent. I'm gonna equip this guy because I know that right up there is a little friend. Spriggan. Spriggan is invisible. Spriggan Guardian. I'm gonna poison her with lingering damage health. Oh wow, she has really good range on that. Oh, got her. And down she goes. What the heck is that? A frost? Is that a lightning cloak? Jeez. That perk is ridiculous. Okay. So the chest is over there. So we'll have to use the hover boots effect again. Let's see if we can get it over there. No. Really, I might be able to. What I might be able to do is jump over there and maybe access the chest. I don't want to fall. Aha! There we go. Okay, there's a Gem of the Swamp, and a Gust Jar. And the Gust Jar is a staff. Here it is. Gust Jar. Gust Jar is a staff. It pulls in air, drawing enemies toward the Wheeler. Turned out really well, actually. So it sends out, like, an unrelenting force effect. And it pulls enemies to you, so let's see. Sort of. Turn off the hover boots here. And I will dispel the rock's cape, because I don't think I'll need it anytime soon. Okay. Ooh, a chest. Another one of those guys. I'll take the lockpicks. Definitely will need those. Yep, there we go. Very much like the hook shot. That tech type. There's a Parotama who wants to have fun. How's it going? Ooh, black tektite. And the Parotamu carrying a Lilian broadsword, Stalfos bone meal, and a banded iron shield. Oh. That one's trapped. However, there is another item up here. Right here. Hummingbird. So first I'm going to take those rupees. Hummingbird is one of the sage weapons. And specifically the one for Saria. And it's a glass dagger, but it is incredibly fast. So it's weak, but like you can see how weak it is. It's only 31. It is very weak, but incredibly fast. Apparently, I am very tired. So I'm going to quickly conjure a bed. Take care of that. My plan is to, so far there's only two sage weapons. I want to add more for each sage. Okay, I'm thirsty. I can deal with that. I just hope I don't have any disease. I'm hungry, thirsty, and wet. I'm low on food. Still hungry. Oh, that's right. That one's dead. All right. So now we're gonna backtrack, back up. Sure. Stairs are a little tough. Did I get there? Oh. This door is now open. So we will be able to access Dilemma, which is the boss arena. And I forgot to quick save, so hopefully it doesn't crash. Because it is loading a world. It's not loading a cell. It's loading an actual exterior. Okay, good. This is the best it's ever looked. Except for that. So I'm gonna quick save. This is where you encounter the boss of the first tower. Actually, I'm gonna use this. Hey! It's a dragon! Specifically, this dragon is a legendary dragon, Aquamentus, from the original Legend of Zelda, if I remember correctly. Obviously, I've sort of reinterpreted it. It has a unique shout. Let's see if they'll do it. He does Fuzroda. But he also has a unique poison shout. I don't know if he'll use it. There's also a chest over here. These chests were originally... So you can bypass the boss. I've been meaning to remove these because the reason why I had these chests in place is in case something went wrong with the boss fight, you could use the chest to get the key and move on. But I've been thinking of getting rid of the chests, or at least getting rid of the keys, because there's very little chance for the dragons to get corrupted anymore. So I'm going to ignore that. Oh, yeah, and it's a full Fuzuro Da. It's not like a just stagger you a little. It's a full-on attack. There he is. How's it going, buddy? I'm going to summon a soldier. Mostly to distract him. Unless it has... No, it doesn't... He doesn't have... She doesn't have a bow, so I didn't get lucky. Why am I firing Dwemer bolts? No bolts equipped. Well, make some with ethereal bolts, you silly game. Okay, I'm firing Dwemer bolts for some reason. And now I'm firing Reekling Spears. Oh, I defeated him. Never use the Poison Shout, but there's a chance that he'll use a Poison Shout that poisons you. Because that's what Poison Shouts do. Alright. So, Doubt Key, Peace of Soul, Sand of Hours, and a Spell Page to summon Aquamentus. And I won't worry about the dragon bones and scales. Good work. I think you deliver the killing blow, actually. There's not much to report in Dilemma. It's just a sort of a messed up forest. There is some funkiness, though. Like, this ground cover is a little high. Those bushes are a little high. I've been meaning to fix that. I think this is actually something not rendering properly. No, that's just a glitch. I'll fix that. I'll be able to fix that. The LODs have always been messed up, so the mountains will pop in and out like that. Yeah, I really need to fiddle with the ground so that everything lines up properly. Don't worry about it. Alright, so we have the Doubt Key, which means we can open this, and we get the Scouring of Kokiri Forest. It's a lore book, and this tells you pretty much exactly what's happening. Well, it'll start to tell you what's happening. So I'm going to read that, and that'll be the end of this episode, and next episode we're going to do the Fire Tower. Scouring of Kokiri Forest. The flow of time is always cruel. Its speed seems different for each person, but no one can change it. A thing that doesn't change with time is a memory of younger days. But those younger days were tainted for me. I had lost 7 years of my life, lived and fought without them, and the prize for my victory was to live them through. I remember the fighting. I remembered an adult body and strength, and I saw the world aged. I could not look at friends without seeing their future. I could not speak to them and grow friendships because I knew the end of the story. I knew that because of my actions 7 years in the future, that their lives would be bright, but I could not bear the agony of knowing. My home was with the Kokiri, woodland sprites who never aged, who never lost their childlike innocence. I envied their joyful lives in their secluded forest. I could never stay there, for I would age. I would lose that innocence, that purity. Done with the battles I waged across time, I departed Hyrule in search of the one friend in whom I could confide, a fairy who had fought with me across time. My search brought me into the depths of the Lost Woods. That was my final error. I fell. A pit deeper than any other swallowed me, and my short, fragmented life flashed before my eyes before the blackness took me. I woke in Termina, a world where the rules were devised by the mind of a mad god. I lived 3 days over and over and over and over, solving Termina's problems, protecting the land from the fall of the moon itself. I saw the moon fall, and I saw it destroy time and time again. I succeeded and failed, rescued Termina from its devastation, and found myself defeated. 3 days again and again. Termina was my purgatory. The days I spent there were in the millions. I never returned to Hyrule, nor did I move on to the realm of the goddesses. I died when I fell, and as the realization dawned on me that Termina was a world between worlds, I faded from it and could only watch as my death destroyed Hyrule and the Kokiri. The Dark Lord knew that I had lived with the Kokiri. He had grown impatient with my absence, as all of Hyrule did. He was obsessed with facing me in battle. He burned the forest, killing my friends and forcing others to take refuge in the Lost Woods. They knew the danger there, but fear of an unknown fate is a powerful motivator. I've never seen them in my misty prison, but I saw them change. I saw some of them become undead. Others became the very forest they loved. One Kokiri was a deeper friend than the rest. She was blessed and protected the forest as a sage. But as she ascended to sagehood, I could no longer see her. I do not know her fate. I doubt that she faced the Dark Lord. Or perhaps it is that I fear that she did. So basically, the story of Relics of Hyrule, I took some inspiration from this fan theory that Termina is purgatory. And I got some criticism for that, for choosing that, but it made sense to me to have Link be dead, and trapped somewhere, that his soul could not be, like, reincarnated. So he ended up getting trapped in Termina, and that kept him from being reincarnated to help fight Ganondorf during the last Great War of Hyrule. And the Scouring of Kokiri Forest takes its name from a chapter of Return of the King, Scouring of the Shire. There are a lot of allusions to other things in Scouring of Kokiri Forest. Scouring of Kokiri Forest. So, for instance, that's a quote from Ocarina of Time. Let's see. Oh, I woke in Termina, a world where the rules were devised by the mind of a mad god. It's actually a reference to Doctor Who, the Rings of Akaten. Done with the battles I waged across time, etc. That's from Majora's Mask. So I'm taking Majora's Mask, Ocarina of Time. Those are both obviously canon. Everything that came before those is canon. For the story of Relics of Hyrule. Alright, that's Doubt. The Ruptured Towers, each individual one is not that long, but there's seven of them. There's seven of them, so it can take a little bit of time. And that is the end of episode 61 of Relics of Hyrule, the series. Our next episode, we will be heading into the next tower. Right over there, it's the Fire Tower. So hope to see you next time. Thanks for watching. Thanks for supporting the mod. I'll see you around.